In our last video, we took Wheeler Engineering's digital trigger pull gauge out for a test drive. This week, we're going to try a similar product from Lyman, their new, second-gen digital trigger pull gauge. The first difference you're likely to notice is the case. Lyman has completely forgone the wimpy bag that came with the previous gen model, and upgraded instead to a hard, plastic case with form-fit foam liner. As with the previous version, they've also included a basic set of instructions. Lyman's also swapped out the 9-volt battery from the previous model with a pair of AAAs. The batteries are actually included with this gauge, which is a really nice touch. Operation is very simple. The trigger rod slides out of the case and can then lock in any one of four different positions. This makes it extremely versatile compared to other gauges on the market, which often have only one or two. As with our testing with the Wheeler gauge, once again I've set up a Smith & Wesson 686, loaded with snap caps, and mounted it in a Workmate. We'll begin by sliding the trigger rod into place and lining it up flush with the trigger. Now it's a simple matter of pulling back gently as straight and slow as possible until the action cycles, yielding a nice, clear reading. Much like with the Wheeler, it took a bit of practice before I was getting good, consistent readings using the Lyman. Also like the Wheeler, I found the key to success is in going slow and smooth. Provided you're willing to make the effort, the Lyman produces some very consistent measurements that line up well to the factory specs for this and other guns that I tried. Starting with the double action trigger pull, I got measurements from a low of 9 pounds 14.5 ounces to a high of 11 pounds 4.1 ounces with an overall average of just under 11 pounds. Transitioning over to the single action tests, I came up with measurements from a low of 1 pound 12.5 ounces to a high of 2 pounds 5.4 ounces with an average of about 2 pounds. While both these measurements are relatively in line for a factory 686, I feel like they're a bit on the low side, though probably still fine for your average user. So how does Lyman's second gen gauge stack up? Well, there's a lot to like about it. The screen is large, clear, and easy to read, including displays for both the active and average values. Construction, while not as solid as the Wheeler, is infinitely more ergonomic. The whole unit is shaped and contoured in a way that makes it simple and comfortable to use for both righties and lefties alike. The trigger rod is really well designed as well. Not only does it have less flex to it than the Wheeler model, but since the sensor is in the main housing, it's much thinner, making it easier to negotiate around small trigger guards as well as accessories like scopes and mounts. Add to the fact that it can snap into four different positions, and you've got yourself a very versatile tool. Lastly, Lyman's decision to include a set of batteries means the second gen digital trigger pull gauge is ready to rock right out of the box. The Lyman second gen definitely has some good points to it, but there's also a few things I don't care for. The first, and definitely the most important thing to me with any tool, is always accuracy, and in this case, I just can't shake the feeling that the Lyman isn't as accurate as it could be. The readings I've gotten from my test firearms have had a greater spread than I saw with the Wheeler, and while they're definitely in the ballpark for factory weights, they still seem to consistently rate on the low side. To be fair, this is still a fairly new tool to me, so it could just be operator error, but I'd be lying if I said I wasn't disappointed. The next thing that really bothers me about the Lyman is the average feature. Despite the fact that you simply press a button after performing a string of up to 10 tests, I found the unit was just as likely to dump my readings, forcing me to start over again, as it was to average them out. That's a very sharp contrast to the Wheeler's interface, which was a pleasure to use and worked flawlessly every time. Likewise, whereas the Wheeler actively displays the number of tests performed and the average all at once, the Lyman has no test count feature at all and requires you to change screens to see your average. My last issue with the Lyman is the lack of a backlight. It probably seems trivial, but if you're working indoors, and chances are you will be, having a backlight can make a real difference when reading the screen, particularly if your eyesight's not what it used to be. I don't want to turn shooters off the Lyman second gen trigger pull gauge. It is a good tool, and it does do what it's supposed to do, but in terms of reliability and quality data, I just don't feel it stands up to Wheeler Engineering's offering. That said, if you're finding the Wheeler's bulk or lack of arm and sensor positions to be a challenge, the Lyman could still make a great option for you.